discuss the mass mass moving in three-dimensional space. Actually, our space real R cube, a real space, in our usual space, the spaces are a three-dimensional. But when you consider the relativistic, then there will be a four. Okay. So as we have discussed that mass moving in a three-dimensional plane. Okay. So if we are considering the mass moving in a three-dimensional space, then there will be a no constraint on the motion of the mass, because there is a no constraint. I'm not asking about the mass moving in a circle or a straight line. There is a no constraint on that. If there is a no constraint, then it means the all coordinate will be good. Whether you solve it in the polar coordinate, whether you will be solved in the Cartesian coordinate, or spherical coordinate, or cylindrical coordinate, or any coordinate, if you solve it in any, all coordinate will be good coordinate for this system, because there is a no constraint. If there is a constraint, then the system may be good, or some coordinate may be a good, and some coordinate may be a bad. So all coordinate will be treated as a generalized coordinate. Okay. What is the Euler-Lagrangian equation in the form of the kinetic energy? We will use this equation जी. हाँ, यस यस. QL. ओके. दिस इज आयलर लग्रांजियन. एक्चुअली आई मस्ट बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू द लग्रांजियन. आई मस्ट नॉट यूज द कनेटिक एनर्जी, बट दिस कोर्स इज अबाउट अंडर ग्रेजुएट कोर्स. दिस कोर्स इज अबाउट द क्लासिकल मैकेनिक्स फॉर अंडर ग्रेजुएट लेवल. एंड because in at undergraduate level you are not able to find the Lagrangian, so we will finding the Lagrangian is out of the scope of your course, and that is difficult for you. But when you will come in advanced level of the courses, advanced courses, as when you come in when you will study the advanced classical mechanics in at MPhil level, then you will be able to find the Lagrangian. Okay. So actually, we know that the kinetic Lagrangian is not only the kinetic energy minus potential energy, and there are other representations also exist. But as I have already explained, because this course is about undergraduate level, so we will use this definition, kinetic energy and the potential energy form. Okay. So as we know, the kinetic energy is a scalar quantity because there is a no indices on it. Okay. If we write it in the form of because all coordinates are good, so all coordinates are good. Since there is no constraints for given system, therefore all coordinates will be good. Since we are not applying any of the constraints, we are not putting any conditions on the motion, so all constraints will be there will be no constraint. If there is a no constraint, then all coordinate will be a good coordinate. Okay, so it means the polar coordinate as well as the Cartesian coordinates, cylindrical, spherical coordinate, every coordinates will be a good, and we are free to choose. Okay. Therefore, if our coordinate will be good, then it mean. The independent for all system, okay, and we may compare the coefficient of QL different we may compare the coefficient, okay. We L is dummy indices, so we may replace with any other indices. So for comparing the coefficient, I write it in this form. Okay, I may replace the L with the K. So this equation will become F Q. Okay. So this will be result, but F, what is the FQ? FQ is force, general force, and it is equal to minus, yes, FEM RM partial QK. That was the expression. So the actually the equation will become we will use this equation. Oh, sorry. This is conventional force. FE external force, okay, function of R, okay, K is free indices on all sides, left at left side as well as the right side. M is a dummy indices, okay. So this equation will be true for the polar coordinate as well as the Cartesian coordinate. We know that for Cartesian, firstly we will solve it for Cartesian coordinate. For Cartesian coordinates, firstly we will solve it for Cartesian coordinate. Okay. For Cartesian coordinates, you know that x qk will be xk for Cartesian. This qk will be replaced with the xk. Okay, and the k value will be 1, 2, 3. Okay, because mass moving in a three dimension, and so this will be x1, x2, x3 with k equal to 1, 2, and 3. Okay? So, and qk dot will be xk dot. And this will be, what will be this? This will be x1 dot, x2 dot, x3 dot. Okay? Very simple, I know. Okay? So this will be a QK. What will be the kinetic energy? Yes. kinetic energy is 1/2 m naught. M naught is, that is mass is non-relativistic. Okay. I using the m naught as a mass is non-relativistic. So you have QL dot because kinetic energy is necessary. So there will be only the dummy indices. Okay. If I using the K, then this indices must be a different than the indices used in already used. Okay. Yahan ke, if you are using the K here, then you must replace it with the L or any other other indices. Okay. It's up to you. Okay. So this will become a 1/2 m naught xl dot. This is a kinetic energy. Okay, simple. Okay, this is a kinetic energy, and so there are three terms, 1, 2, and 3. We have to find the three things. 1, 2, and 3. So firstly, we find the kinetic energy QK. Okay, QK. I can say that 1/2 m naught partial XL dot. XL dot. Okay, because according to our course, X dot according to undergraduate level, the velocity will be independent because there is no semi-holonomic constraint for a simple mechanics or undergraduate level. Okay, but when you move towards the advanced classical mechanics, then there will be or when you move toward the classical mechanics or general dynamics, that is also the play, that is also available on my YouTube lectures in the name of the classical mechanics for the general dynamics. Okay, then this L will be so then that will be not independent because position and momentum may be connected with the constraints, semi holonomic constraints. Okay, but in your course is based on the holonomic constraints. Your course also include the semi holonomic constraint, but according to your course, these are the for undergraduate level, the XL and X position and velocity are independent, and for undergraduate level, graduate level course, partial x l over partial x zero, position and velocity is zero, so this will be a zero. But this is true only for the undergraduate level course. I again repeat, this will be true only for the undergraduate level course. Okay. This will be the result. This is equation 1. Okay. Okay. If I take the derivative with respect to m naught is non-relativistic, that's why that will be constant. Okay. Kinetic energy. What is the kinetic energy? XL dot XL XK. Okay. so x sorry x dot okay okay the derivative of x with the x is 1 and derivative of x with the y is 0 so you will have one half m naught the product formula will be applied okay derivative of first second will be as it plus first will be as it the derivative will be applied on second okay clear okay so you will have this will be at two will be cancelled when this will be at that will be two so result will be m naught xk naught sorry okay and this will be equal to m dot because mass is constant with respect to time formula m dot why m dot is m dot is constant with respect to time or non relativistic mechanics okay so this will be your third result okay not two sorry this will be second so you have proved 1 2 and now the term is the third about third or you will find the third what is the f m r e no I have to find what is this okay here k is free indices that mean we have considered one and there is summation okay so this will be f e r m partial x m okay the dot product and that mean they have a this is sorry this is xk okay since there is a dot product means there is summation that mean that is fm e okay this will be a when you are taking the dot product so it's mean there if you are I mean if you consider that I explore it to f1 one unit vector fe2 two unit vector plus fe3 three unit vector yes and this will be x1 one unit vector plus x2 मैंने I have put the value of the mean. Okay. 2 unit vector plus x3 3 unit vector. Okay. And we are taking the partial derivative with respect to x. Xk is fixed, that is any one. Okay. So after taking the dot product, mean if you consider dot product, it means if that is one, that will be one. If two, then that will be two. Okay. So it means because this is there is a force component, okay, and there is also a force component, position component. So when you take the dot product, that means when you take the dot product one with the one, that will be one. But when you take the dot product one with the two or with the three, that will be a zero. Yes. So it means all component will be removed. Only one component will be remained. Okay. So it means you have f. I have roughly write it to explain. Okay. So this when you take this dot product, that will become a component if that is along the FER. So that will become a canonical delta Fk. Okay, and when we take the canonical delta will be changed this M with K, and its component will be only along the that axis. Mean the R component will be zero. Only the two components will be mean. You will get F E as a function of R that will be equal to M will be replaced with the K. This will be the result, and this will be third. Putting all these 1, 2, 3 in equation x, this one, this two, this is two, one, two, and three. Putting 1, 2, and 3 in equation x, you have क्या रिजल्ट आ जाएगा. यू विल गेट द रिजल्ट. यू विल गेट व्हाट विल बी द रिजल्ट. एफ के फोर्स, एक्सटर्नल फोर्स विल बी इक्वल टू एम नॉट के दिस. दैट विल बी दिस रिजल्ट. ओके, means if this is 1, then that will be 1. Yani if the external force is along x-axis, then that will be along the x-axis. That is the, actually what is that? That is Newton's second law of motion. So you may use this all calculations to find the Newtonian, mean that will be consistent with the Newton law. Okay, so if that is x-axis, then that will be along x-axis. If that is along the two of y-axis, then that will be acceleration will be along y-axis. If force is along the z-axis, then the that will be the along the z-axis. Okay, I think that is a very simple and okay. So next is about the question is same, mass moving in a three dimension, but if we solve it in the polar coordinate, what will be happen? Okay. पास नहीं है इसमें, इसमें पास है। नाउ वी विल सॉल्व इट फॉर अ पोलर कोऑर्डिनेट। ओके, इफ आई ड्रॉ दिस पिक्चर, ओके, नाउ वी आर सॉल्विंग इट फॉर अ पोलर, एक्चुअली पोलर मीन स्फेरिकल कोऑर्डिनेट बिकॉज इट इज इन अ थ्री डायमेंशन, ठीक है, मीन स्फेरिकल, वी मे सॉल्व इट फॉर अ सिलेंड्रिकल कोऑर्डिनेट बट वी विल सॉल्व ओनली फॉर द स्फेरिकल कोऑर्डिनेट बिकॉज द अवर कोर्स रिक्वायरमेंट इज टू सॉल्व इट द स्फेरिकल पोलर कोऑर्डिनेट, ठीक है, स्फेरिकल। स्फेरिकल पोलर कोऑर्डिनेट, सो वी विल सॉल्व इट फॉर स्फेरिकल पोलर कोऑर्डिनेट, द फिगर विल रिमेन द सेम, ओके, देर विल बी नो चेंज इन अ फिगर बट द फिगर विल बी कन्वर्ट इन टू दी पोलर कोऑर्डिनेट, ओके। Okay, as we have done last time, yes. If this is a theta, okay, I think I have used theta for this and phi, okay, if this is theta, and this will be, if this is a rho, okay, if I considering the very small change, okay, and what is that? That will be delta theta, okay. And this will be rho, this arc length will be rho delta theta, okay, if I draw a perpendicular on the xy plane, not I think blue color is not appropriate, I draw this, okay, if the change in this is xy plane and this is change in angle phi, okay, and then that will be a delta phi, okay. If I draw the projection on this, if this is projection, okay, projection of this, and this will be equal to according to this rho will be equal to this, and this is rho sine theta. Okay, so this will be, this is equal and equal in magnitude, okay, and have same direction, and but direction we are considering only the magnitude. This will be a sine, rho sine. This will be a rho, yes, rho sine theta. This is angle phi. In xy plane, the change in is angle phi, as with this angle, and that will be change in this angle theta. Okay, so the result will be rho sine theta. No, this is rho sine theta, and this is arc length. To find the this arc length, this is arc. That will be rho sine theta. ओके, क्लियर हो गया. रो साइन थीटा डेल्टा, ओके, डन. सो नो व्हाट इज द चेंज, QK has a three component as in this way, K x1, x2, x3. Okay, similarly as I have already, everything will be like as discussed, already discussed, so there will be no change, but the x1 will be in polar, in spherical polar coordinate. What will be the x1? Road. Oh, okay. Sorry. So you will get this. Okay. What are their coordinate? X one is, there are three things. X one. Rho x2, there is change in theta, and final is phi. So x1 is rho, mean they are three component. X qk is rho theta phi. Okay. But dot is not like that, unfortunately. Why? This is rho theta phi. Okay. One, Q1 is, actually this is Q1, Q1 is rho, Q2 is, actually this is not X1, X2, X3, I must write that. This is QK, that is Q1, Q2, and Q3. So the coordinates are rho theta and phi. They are three coordinates, okay? And and the complete QK change in QK, what is the change? One, oh sorry, change in QK is rho, okay, delta rho, difference is delta rho, okay, rho delta rho रो यूनिट वेक्टर, ओके, प्लस रो डेल्टा रो, रो यूनिट वेक्टर अलोंग द रो, प्लस रो नहीं सॉरी ओनली डेल्टा रो, डिफरेंस इज डेल्टा रो, डेल्टा रो यूनिट वेक्टर, ओके, एंड रो डेल्टा थीटा, थीटा यूनिट वेक्टर प्लस रो साइन थीटा डेल्टा फाई, फाई यूनिट वेक्टर, ओके, दिस इज दिस, ओके, अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस 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 रो यूनिट वेक्टर थीटा, थीटा यूनिट वेक्टर, रो साइन थीटा डी फाई, फाई यूनिट वेक्टर, ओके, 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 सो दिस इज डेल्टा क्यू व्हेन वी अप्लाई लिमिट अप्रोच टू जीरो, ओके, both sides, then the change will become infinitesimal small and that will be localized, okay, when it will be localized then this delta change delta will be converted into the d derivative, okay, so when we localize then that will be dqk, what will be that, that will be d rho dqk will be d rho, rho unit vector plus rho d theta, theta unit vector plus rho sine theta d phi, phi unit, okay, and when we take with derivative with respect to dt then that will be our dq dot, okay, the derivative will apply derivative will apply only on the change, okay, and the velocity will become a this qk dot will become, what will be this, this will be rho dot rho unit vector plus rho theta dot theta unit vector plus rho sin theta phi dot phi unit vector, this will be the result, this is the result of the velocity, okay, and what is will be the kinetic energy, kinetic energy is 1 half m naught, okay,
ऊपर एक बार इन सब के साथ a phi d theta d rho प्लस ब्रैकेट बंद
क्या नहीं ये है ना, दिस इज योर चेंज। आपने जहां 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 डेल आ रहा है वहां वहां आपका डेरिवेटिव हो जाएगा, व्हेन यू टेक विद रिस्पेक्ट टू टाइम। ओके, सो दिस विल बी दी वन हाफ एम नॉट। ओके, व्हाट इज द काइनेटिक एनर्जी? काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज क्यू के डॉट विद क्यू के डॉट, दैट वाज द काइनेटिक एनर्जी। ओके, एंड दिस विल बिकम वन हाफ एम नॉट रो डॉट रो यूनिट वेक्टर रो थीटा डॉट थीटा यूनिट वेक्टर प्लस रो साइन थीटा फाइ डॉट फाइ यूनिट वेक्टर। ओके, when we take the dot product, the same component will be multiplied. Yes? Okay. Okay, in dot product, all components will be independent. Okay, so that's why the same component, the unit, the magnitude of the rho with the rho will be 1, but rho with the theta will be 0. So all components will be removed. Okay, so the result will be m naught rho dot square plus rho theta dot square plus rho sine theta phi dot square. This will be the kinetic energy. Okay, and now we have to find 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so when we take the derivative of the kinetic energy with respect to, now we will solve for different. Okay, q1 is rho, q2 is theta, q3 is phi. Firstly, we will solve it for q k equal to q1, that is, what is that? That is rho. Firstly, we will solve it for rho. Okay, so when we take the derivative with respect to rho, it will become 1/2 m naught. Derivative of velocity with respect to position, that will be 0, okay? 0 plus power will be shift 2 rho theta dot, okay? Rho is constant and theta, no. Okay, when take derivative, power will be shift 2 and it become a rho theta dot, and then derivative of this, okay, you will take the derivative rho theta dot with respect to partial rho. So derivative of rho with rho 1, or theta dot is constant with respect to rho. Okay, so this will be a rho dot partial rho and partial rho, that is 1, okay, because it is equal to 1. Okay, so we may write directly. Okay, theek hai, plus similarly 2 rho, 2 rho sine theta, okay? And derivative with respect to rho, so sine theta will be constant, and okay, and we take derivative of rho sine theta with respect to rho, sine theta will be constant, that will be come out, and derivative of rho with rho, that will be of 1, okay? So sine theta, and phi dot square is constant, yes? Phi dot square is constant, yes? Okay, because we are taking derivative with respect to rho, not phi. Okay, so what will be the result? Kinetic energy over rho. What will be that? 2 will be cancelled out. We can take the common. Okay, m naught rho theta dot square plus sine square theta phi dot square. Okay, simple. This is the question 1. Okay. Now we will take the question 2. So we will try to find the question 2. Equation 2 is rho dot. Rho dot. Okay. Yes. Okay. Why I am using not indices 1, 2, 3? Because Q1 is rho. Okay. So that's why that is understood. Okay. That will be a rho dot. And now what will be the result? This is 1/2. M naught, okay, that will be constant. Mass, we are considering the non-relativistic mechanics. So the mass is constant, and this is kinetic energy, okay? When we take derivative of this with respect to rho dot, 2 rho dot, okay, and plus, okay, derivative with respect to rho dot, this is 0 and this is also 0, r term is 0, hence r, okay, that's simple. So this 2 will be cancelled with this 2. Okay, and this will be m naught. When we take the derivative rho dot with respect to time, that will be rho double dot. And this will be equation 2. Okay, and what will be the third equation? Okay. What is the third? F E M dot partial M over partial QK. Now we have to find this, okay? This force E is is 1. Okay. M1 plus 2, 3, okay? Rho plus force थीटा प्लस फोर्स फाइव, मीन इफ दैट इज रो, इफ यू आर, नो सॉरी, ओके वी हैव टू राइट रो, रो यूनिट वेक्टर प्लस थीटा, थीटा यूनिट वेक्टर प्लस फाइव यूनिट वेक्टर, एंड व्हाट इज दिस, दिस वाज दिस, नो दिस वाज, दिस यस, दिस व्हाट वाज दिस, आई हैव ऑलरेडी, आई थिंक आई हैव अरेज्ड इट, मीन डेल्टा विल रिप्लेस विद द डी, ओके पार्शल, दिस इज विल बी पार्शल पार्शल, दिस डेल्टा विल बी रिप्लेस विद पार्शल, ओके बिकॉज वी आर डिस्कसिंग पार्शल, पार्शल रो, रो यूनिट वेक्टर ओवर पार्शल रो, ओके बिकॉज के इज फिक्स दैट इज रो, ओके प्लस पार्शल रो, दूसरा क्या था, रो पार्शल थीटा ओवर पार्शल रो थीटा डॉट, ऐसे ही प्लस रो साइन थीटा पार्शल फाई ओवर रो, पार्शल फाई ओवर पार्शल रो, हम रो से ही ले रहे हैं ना, एंड दैट विल बी एंड ऑल टर्म विल बी जीरो बिकॉज डेरिवेटिव विद रिस्पेक्ट टू अदर दैट विल बी जीरो, सो ऑल विल बी जीरो, ओके ओनली दी दिस कंपोनेंट विल बी रिमेन, ओके सो दिस एंड दिस, वैसे भी डॉट प्रोडक्ट इसके अंदर, ओके सो यू विल हैव एफ ई, रो का डेरिवेटिव रो से वन आ जाएगा, दिस विल बी रो, ओके ओके एंड दिस इज इक्वेशन थ्री, ओके और हियर वाज, दिस इज प्लस नॉट माइनस सॉरी, ओके when we convert it into the potential then that will be become a negative, that's it, okay so putting 1 2 3 1 2 and 3 in equation, this equation x, okay then you will get 1 2 and 3 in equation x, what will be the result, F rho E that will be equal to, yes F rho will be equal to M naught rho double dot plus M naught will be common rho theta dot square plus rho sine square theta phi dot square, this will be result, okay okay I think very simple, okay so now we will do it for a है? जल्दी जल्दी कर लेते आज खत्म, इफ वी डू इट फॉर इट टू, ओके एक कंप्लीट हो रही है चीज उसको होने दो, इफ वी डू इट फॉर टू देन दैट विल बी थीटा, ओके if we do it for a theta, okay, the meaning is same. If we do it for theta, okay, this is theta, this, okay, if we take derivative with respect to theta, okay, now it will become a theta, okay. So first zero, this is also zero, kinetic energy, this is not, yes, here zero because there is theta dot is independent from theta, only this term will become, okay, here is a theta. So power will be shift to rho sine theta, power will be shift to rho sine theta, okay, and rho is constant, rho come out with respect to theta, derivative of sine theta with respect to theta, that will be a cos theta, and derivative of theta with respect to theta, that is 1, okay, mean d theta over d theta, that is 1, that is 1, so that, okay, this will be the result, okay, simple. Here will be theta dot, here will be theta dot, okay, now we are solving for theta 2, okay, theta dot. Okay, and so okay. Okay, now it's and what will be this? Theta dot this zero. But here is a theta dot, that will be 2 rho theta dot, firstly it will power will be shifted, and then that will be rho because rho is constant, and derivative of theta dot with respect to theta dot, that is 1, okay, this term is 0, and we are taking the derivative with respect to theta, so this term will be also 0 because here is no theta dot, so this will be result, okay, and 2 will be 2, cancel with the 2, okay, you may say that that is m naught, okay, we may say that this is m naught rho square theta dot. Okay, when we take the derivative with respect to time, both are a function of time, so product formula will be applied, m naught first function as it, derivative of second, that will be double dot, plus 2 rho, power will be shift, rho dot theta dot, okay, theta dot because the second function will be added, okay, and this is the your second, okay, okay, what is the third? व्हाट अबाउट दिस थर्ड? एफ एम के एफ एम इज हम एग्जैक्टली दिखा सकते हैं एफ एम एफ एम एफ एम एफ एम इज कंप्लीट ओके एफ एम आर ई पार्शल पार्शल आर एम ओवर क्यू क्यू के इज थीटा यस थीटा क्यू के इज थीटा यस So M dot for when we take the only the M component will become okay. The every component will be removed, only the theta component because all derivative will be zero. Yes, I have already checked, so don't need to repeat. Rho kya aa jayega? F M yaar F M E dot derivative theta with respect to theta is 1 rho theta dot okay so here rho theta dot so rho fm e theta dot okay when we take the dot product m is 1 2 3 okay four. So that will become rho f theta okay this is your third and I think now it is clear okay so one two, when we put one two and three in x we have rho f e theta is equal to what is the one yes M naught will be common. Rho square sine theta cos phi phi dot plus rho square theta double dot plus 2 rho rho dot theta dot. So this will be your the result. Okay. Okay, M naught rho square sine theta cos theta. Cos theta phi dot square. Yes. Plus rho rho theta dot plus 2 rho theta dot phi dot. Okay. Very simple. Okay. Now the last is about when we consider the phi. If we consider third part, third Q3 that is phi. Okay, if we do it for a phi. Yes. What will be the result? And first zero, second zero, only third will be. And that will be rho sine theta square. Okay. Rho sine theta square 2 phi dot. Power will is 2 phi dot and derivative of phi dot no okay sorry with respect to phi first zero there is no phi second zero no phi that is simple zero okay this is one. Okay. If we take derivative with respect to two, if we consider the second. Phi dot, okay, 1/2 m naught is constant with respect to time as well as the, that's why I've taken the common, okay. Please, okay. So वो उधर कोई था तो m naught आ जाएगा. So 1/2 m naught आ गया आपके पास. Phi dot क्या आ जाएगा आपके पास? 5 dot के रिस्पेक्ट पहला 0, 5 dot ये भी 0, rho sin theta square 2 phi dot, and phi dot derivative with respect to phi dot is 1, okay. This, okay, when you apply the this two will be cancelled with the this two, so you will get m naught rho square sin square theta phi dot. Okay. So you will get m naught as it 1, 2, 3. There's a three terms. Firstly we apply on first, then second, then third. So if we apply the derivative on first, that will be 2 rho dot, okay, because derivative with respect to time, okay, when to take a total derivative with respect to time, that will be dot, okay, 2 rho dot sine square theta and phi dot will be as it plus rho square will be as it 2 sin theta, derivative of sin theta is cos theta, and theta dot, okay. When we take the derivative of theta with theta dot, 2 sin theta, derivative of sin theta will be cos theta, and derivative of theta is a time, that will be theta dot. This, okay, and phi dot, okay, plus third is rho square sin square theta phi double dot. Yes. And okay. And what will be this? Third, partial d theta component. Okay, theta component is no phi component. No, third you are considering the Q3 phi. For phi, what will be the for phi? This is 2. Phi kya hai? Aapke paas फाई, व्हाट इज द फाई? रो साइन थीटा पार्शियल फाई ओवर पार्शियल फाई, ओके, एंड फाई यूनिट वेक्टर, ओके ओके, एंड दिस विल बी एफ एम, ओके, रो साइन थीटा पार्शियल फाई दैट इज इक्वल टू वन, ओके, रो साइन फाई एफ एम ई फाई यूनिट वेक्टर, सो दिस विल बी रो साइन थीटा एफ ई फाई, ओके, दिस विल बी एफ के क्यू थर्ड, ओके, पुटिंग वन टू थ्री ऑल टूगेदर, सो वन टू एंड थ्री इन दैट्स वी हैव रो साइन थीटा एफ ई फाई दैट विल बी इक्वल टू एम नॉट, ठीक है, एम नॉट टू रो रो डॉट साइन स्क्वायर थीटा फाई डॉट, ठीक है, प्लस टू रो स्क्वायर साइन थीटा कॉस थीटा फाई थीटा डॉट फाई डॉट प्लस रो स्क्वायर साइन स्क्वायर थीटा फाई डबल डॉट. So this will be the result. For today it is enough. Okay, I think. Okay. So close the lecture. ठीक है. आज के लिए.